Hey guys, it's Glenn from glennscarcollection.com, and today I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about the 2025 BMW M3. If you like these kind of videos, remember to subscribe, hit the notification bell. I do one full video every Monday and shorts during the week, so you got to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss it. Like and share this video so our channel can grow, and as always, leave a comment below. All right, so the first thing you'll see about the 2025 M3 is the big grills are still there. That was rumored for a while that that's going to disappear. Some of the changes are a little more obvious, some are less obvious, and there's also a horsepower bump, so remember to watch this video all the way through. So one thing you'll notice is it's got new wheels are available, and I actually like them. I think this green with the black goes well. Steering wheel. Flat bottom steering wheel with a red marker at the 12 o'clock position. There's also a new iDrive, which we'll get to in a second. The headlights now have a update. You can see they combine the low beam and the high beam into a single unit. The M3 badge in the back is actually different, and so are the tail lights. Now, what is all this called? This is called a life cycle impulse, and basically that's a facelift for the car halfway through the model's life cycle of the G80. Now, BMW purists, when it comes to use values, because usually enthusiasts buy these cars used after they've depreciated, they love LCI for the car, whether it's an E92 M3 or V10 M5 M6, they love the LCI cars. So this may be the one to get because it may have a much better resale value. Now for the three M3 models, one of them is going to have a horsepower bump. So let's start with the not so obvious first. So you have the curved display and the new operating system. So this is known as iDrive 8.5. And basically they're trying to take some buttons away. So there's new controls for climate control. I'm probably old school and still want to have more buttons in the car, but basically it's supposed to be, according to BMW, a new simplified climate control interface with temperature, ventilation, and seat heating. Steering wheel heating can also be controlled with the touch display or a dedicated menu or voice command. BMW says further, and I quote, a further reduction in the number of buttons and controls in the cockpit. Now, they say that's a selling point. I kind of prefer that there's more hard buttons like my E90 M3 had, but that's the price of technology. So pricing, so again, we have three models and we'll go over them. There's the base sedan. So remember, the base sedan is only available with a six-speed manual and its rear drive. The price, MSRP for 2025, base price will be $77,175. Then there's two competition models. The regular competition sedan, which is rear drive, and the competition X-Drive sedan, which is all-wheel drive. So if you want the competition, you can get rear drive or all-wheel drive, but you're stuck with the eight-speed automatic. The price for the competition sedan with the automatic and with rear drive is $81,375. So roughly $4,000 than the rear drive manual. And again, this car is rear drive as well. Now, if you want the king of the hill, the 2025 M3 Competition X Drive, and that's BMW speak for all-wheel drive, that's about $5,000 or $5,100 more than the competition sedan rear drive. Confused yet? So the X Drive is now up to $86,475, and that's before options. Now remember, all the engines are still the 3-liter turbocharged six-cylinder engine. The rear drive version weighs 3,840 pounds. The M3 Competition, 3,891 pounds, so about 50 pounds more. They are long cars. My E46 M3 and even my 2016 M2, they're about 176 inches in length, a little less than that, maybe 175. Now it's same as the pre-LCI version. The G80 is 189 inches long, so that's like almost a previous 5 Series. I think it might even be bigger than that. 0 to 60 time with the manual, and I've tested this car. I tested the M4 manual, which is essentially the same thing, 2 doors instead of 4. 4.1 seconds to 60. If you see my M4 manual rear drive video, we got quicker than that. And on the competition rear drive, 3.8 seconds to 60, because you got 503 horsepower instead of 473. Now the M3 competition X drive, so you have the 8-speed auto, in this case extra horsepower, so you're going to have 523 horsepower. It gets a 20 horsepower bump over the M3 competition rear drive. So again, the horsepowers are 473 for the rear drive manual, 503 for the competition 8-speed auto, still rear drive. And then the big dog, if you want to call it that, the M3 competition X drive gets a 20 horsepower boost from 503 horsepower to 523. And that drops the 0 to 60. Remember, this has all-wheel drive, and it's the only variant with all-wheel drive, and an 8-speed automatic shifts faster than you and I can. Drops that 0 to 60 time from 3.8 seconds to 3.4 seconds. And BMW, like Porsche and all German brands, are pretty conservative with the 0 to 60 times. So I wouldn't be surprised if we see 3.1, 3.2, 3.3, 0 to 60, which is astonishing. Figure this car, with options, if the base price was $86,000, probably about $95,000, somewhere in that range, $92,000, $93,000. All right, guys, let me know what you would buy. Remember, individual colors are out too. You can get Laguna Seca Blue now for 2025, which you should get so I can buy from you in a couple years with slightly used. All right, thanks again for watching, and I will see you next time.